by the end of this video, you'll be able to draw a mechanical connecting rod in AutoCAD. The first step is to have a sketch of what we have in mind to draw and its dimensions. The next step is to open the AutoCAD software. Next, press F7 on the keyboard to toggle the grid lines off, or you can click the grid lines icon on the status bar. Next, let's consider our sketch drawing. From this center to this center is 172 millimeters. Next, we're going to pick the line command. Next, we're going to pick a point on the screen. Next, we want to draw a straight line. To draw a straight line in AutoCAD, you need to press F8 on the keyboard. F8 will help you to draw a straight line that will only be 0, 90, 180, 270, or 360. Next, we're going to type a line of 150 and press enter twice. Next, with the roller mouse, we're going to zoom this line open. Next, we're going to click the line command. Next, we're going to locate the midpoint and click. If you can't locate this midpoint, press escape on the keyboard and type oh snap. Press enter and a dialog box will appear. On this drafting settings dialog box, click select all for now and click OK. Next, click the line command. Next, click this midpoint. Next, type 172. Next, press enter twice. Next, type offset. Press enter. Next, type 172 and press enter. Click this line and click this side. Press enter. Next, click this line. Next, click copy. Pick this line from here and find this middle. Click and enter. What we have done is this line is here and we got a line here, and we located the middle of this line. From here to this point is 40, and from here to this point is also 40. Next, we're going to type offset. Press enter. We're going to type 40. Press enter. Click this line and click this side. Click this line and click this side and press enter. Next, we have two circles here. One of the circle is 17.8 millimeters and the other circle is 22.5 millimeters. Next, we're going to click the circle command. Click this point and type 17.8 and press enter. Next, we're going to pick the circle command again. Click this point and this time around we're going to type 22.5 and press enter. Next, we have this little rectangle of 4.05 millimeters by 13.6 millimeters. Next, press escape on the keyboard. Next, click trim command. Trim here off, trim here off. trim here off, and trim here off. Next, press escape. Next, type join and press enter. Click this arc, click this line, click this arc, press enter. This is now one object. Press escape. You can see we have achieved this. Next, from this point to this point, the connecting rod thickness is 25.4 millimeters. That means I will offset up 12.7, offset down 12.7. Next, I will type offset and press enter. I will type 12.7, press enter. I will click this and click up. I will click this line and click down and press enter. Next, these lines are not touching the circle on 4 points. Next, type extend and press enter. Click this line, click this line, click this line, and click this line. Press enter on the keyboard. Next, on this side of the connecting rod, the fillet here is 22.5, and on this side of the connecting rod, the fillet is 43 millimeters. Next, we're going to fillet this edge. Before I do this, let me show you a problem you are going to encounter in AutoCAD when you want to fillet two objects that are not a polyline. Let me make this mistake, then I will later show you the right thing to do. I will click or type fillet and press enter. R, enter. I will enter a fillet of 22.5. I'll press enter. I will click this and click this. You see, AutoCAD have cut off this part of the drawing. If, let me press Ctrl Z to restore my drawing. Let me fillet this side. Fillet, R, enter. I will enter 43, press enter. If I click here, this line and this, can you see it worked? On this side, if I click here and click here, it's fine. However, if I press fillet, radius, 22.5, enter. If I click this and I decide to click this, AutoCAD is telling me cannot fillet between these two lines. If I ignore this warning and I click, it will cut it off. Now let us do it the right way. Next, escape and press Ctrl Z. I want to restore everything back. What we're going to do here in order to avoid this problem is click or type trim and press enter. Next, trim here off and trim here off. Next, trim here and trim here. You can see after we have trimmed this, this entire line continues to this. I'll press escape on the keyboard. Next, I'm going to click or type fillet. Next, I will press R and press enter. Next, I will type 22.5. I'll press enter. I will click this circle and this line. Next, I will click this circle and this line. Now, here is fine now. I might even delete this line. Next, I want to fillet this part of the connecting rod. I will click or type fillet. R, I'll press enter. This side, the fillet is 43. I'll press enter. I'll click this line. Now AutoCAD is telling me I cannot do this. If I go ahead and do it, it just ignored me. What I will do now is, if I click any part of this line, you discover that when I filleted here, AutoCAD automatically joined everything. But this part of the object is not joined. To fillet this, I will type join and press enter. I will click this and click this object, enter. If I click any part of this, everything is now a polyline. I will press escape on the keyboard. Next, you click or you type fillet. Next, R, you press enter. Next, you accept this 43 or type 43 and press enter. Next, I will click this line and click this. Next, I will repeat the same fillet on this side. And now you can see we have our connecting rod. Or I will say that the shape of our connecting rod is gradually coming out. Next, I'm going to delete these lines. Next, we have a rectangle here. And this rectangle is a rectangle of 30 millimeters by 15 millimeters. Next, I will pick the rectangle command. I'll pick a point on the screen. I will type at 30, 15. I'll press enter. Next, I'm going to click on this groove. Copy. With the copy command, I'm going to make a copy of this. I will click just somewhere here and enter. Next, I will switch this workspace to southwest isometric view. I will click and we got this. Next, I will click this line and delete this line. Next, I will type press pull. I'll press enter. I will click inside this and go up by 9 and press enter. Next, I'll press escape on the keyboard. Next, I will go to view. I will click palette, visual style. And let us see what we have done. Next, I will hold the shift key on the keyboard down. Use the roller mouse and turn this to the other side of the bottom by orbit. Next, I will type press pull. Press enter. Next, I will click this part and come down 9 and press enter. This is a total thickness of 18 millimeters. Next, we're going to click top view. Next, we're going to click wireframe. Next, we're going to go to home, pick a line, and I will click quadrant to quadrant, enter. Likewise, I will click quadrant to quadrant. I'll press enter. Next, click southwest isometric view. Next, I will click one of these to enable us to see our object. Next, I'm going to extrude this. EST, enter. I will extrude this by 6. I will press enter. Next, I will click top view. Next, I will click this. Next, I will click move. I will pick this from the center. If I can locate the center, click here and drop it at the center. Next, I will click southwest isometric view. Now you can see that we now have a groove here. If it is not at the center, we can still move it up. Next, we're going to pick the circle command. We're going to click a point and we're going to type 33, enter. Next, we're going to pick another circle from this center. We're going to type 36 and press enter to pick the line command and locate this quadrant to the other quadrant. Next, I will use press pull, enter. This, I want it to be 38 millimeter long. I will click this. I'll press pull up 19. I'll press enter. I will use orbit, or I will hold the shift key down, use my ruler mouse and turn this up to see the bottom. I will click this and press pull down 19. Press enter. Now, this is a total thickness of 38. Next, I'll press escape on the keyboard. Next, I will highlight these two. Next, I will click move. Next, I will pick the middle of this inner line. Then, I will drop it at this line here. Now, I have this. Next, I will pick the circle command. I will pick a point, 20. I'll press enter. I'll pick the circle command again. I will locate the midpoint of this circle. Click. From the center of this circle, I will type 17.8. I'll press enter. Next, I'll pick the line command. I will locate the quadrant. The inner circle, quadrant to quadrant. I will enter. Next, I will type press pull. I will press enter. I will click this in between circles. I will go up 19. I will press enter. I will hold down my shift key and with the ruler mouse, I will turn this on the other face. Next, I will click this. I will come down 19. I will press enter. This is a total of 38 millimeter thickness. Next, I'll press escape. Next, I will highlight this. I will click move. I will locate the middle of this line and drop it at the center of this line. Now, I have this. I will delete this line. Next, I will extrude this rectangle. Next, I will type press pull. I will press enter. Next, I will click this rectangle. I will go up by 9. I'll press enter. Next, with the orbit, I will click the bottom part, come down 9 and press enter. This is a total thickness of 18 millimeters. Next, I'll press escape key. I will click 2D wireframe. I will carefully locate the end of this line. End of this line is here. Next, I will highlight this rectangle. I will click copy. I will copy this from the center of this line, not this midpoint. I will pick this from this midpoint, not the geometrical center. I will click. I will locate the end of this line and click. I will press escape. Let us see what we have done. Next, I will click on this object. I will click mirror. I will locate the midpoint. I will click and keep my hand straight and click. I'll press enter. Now I got this. Next, we're going to create a hole here and also a hole on the other side. And if I try to click and create a circle, you see my circle will be in this orientation. To change this, I will type UCS and press enter. Next, on the status bar, I will click Z axis. I will pick this face and click this direction. Now, if I pick the circle command, you see what I got now. This radius is 4.5. I'll press enter. I'll pick this circle, copy, and drop it here. Press escape. Next, I will click this circle. Next, I will click move. I'm going to move this circle from the center, and I will now locate the other end. Now, if I find it difficult to drop this circle here, I will click out, escape. I will pick line, click and click and enter. Now I can move this circle. Let me move this circle out. Now I can gradually move this circle to this line. Let me be sure it is on that face. Yes. And for the other one, that's fine. Next, type press pull. Next, click this face and pull it out on the other side. Next, click this face and pull it out on the other side. Also, click this face and pull it out on the other side. Next, escape. Now you can see we have created a hole. You can click this and delete it. We still need to press pull here. Next, we're going to type press pull, enter. We click here, press pull out and enter. Next, escape. Next, to bring our UCS back to normal, we're going to type UCS and press enter. Here, we're going to click on world UCS. Our UCS is back to normal. I can click top view, keep clicking it until you get the correct orientation. Now, our UCS is back to normal. I can click southwest isometric view, and this is what we have. I will click this and delete it. Next, I will check making sure that everything is okay. Next, I will type union. I will press enter. Next, I will highlight everything. I will press enter. Next, I will click any part of this connecting rod. I will click move. I will move this out and click. Now you see all the lines that have helped us to actually draw this. I will delete all these lines and press delete on the keyboard. Now I have the connecting rod only. Next, I will click fillet, R on the keyboard and enter. Enter 9 for the radius of the fillet. Press enter. Next, I will click this edge and enter twice. Next, I'll press enter. I'll click this edge and enter twice. I will repeat same to the other side. Next, click or type fillet. Click the edge of this rectangle. Enter twice. Enter again. Click the other edge. Enter twice. Now we have this. You can click this visual style to see different shapes of the connecting rod. Next, click top view. Next, change this to 2D wireframe. Next, pick the line command. Locate the middle of this circle. Click and click anywhere up here. Enter. Extend this line down here. Escape. Next, type slice and press enter. However, before we slice this, press escape. Highlight this. Make a copy of this connecting rod. Press enter. We're going to slice this. Next, type slice and press enter. Click this connecting rod. Press enter. Here on the taskbar, we're going to choose 3 points. However, when you entered, automatically 3 points is highlighted. Now I have clicked 3 points. I'm going to click 3 points along this line. I will click on this object, 1. I will locate another part, 2. Then I will locate another part here, 3. And AutoCAD is asking me, do I want to keep both? I will enter to accept yes. Now you wouldn't see anything that has happened, but this has been sliced along this path. I will click southwest isometric view. I will click realistic. Next, I will click this part of the connecting rod. Next, I will click move. I will click and just move it out a bit. I will click. With orbit, you are going to see that I have sliced our connecting rod along this path. I hope this video was helpful. If you enjoyed this video, click the like button. Also, subscribe for more videos like this. I will see you in the next one.